My name is Peter. Just testing how far this... Ah, it can't work if I don't switch it on. This will be about how to work effective, how to spoil the efficiency of your development team, or if spoil your efficiency if you're a developer, and how to pimp it, how to really get it going. My background is the following. I have been a very lucky guy because at some point I get into connection with Zen, like in Zen meditation. And I'm a very lucky guy because I had a mentor who teach me one thing, and that is nothing spiritual is of worth if you can't use it in your all-day life and if it does not improve your all-day life. So that's where I started to think about how can I integrate what I learned with Zen into all-day life. Now in Zen, they have something called koans. Koans are kind of riddles, kind of mental exercise for the students. And at one point, one master said to a new student, I'd like to give you something to help in your process, but in Zen we have nothing. Hopefully at the end of the presentation of this workshop, you'll know why and how this is a kind of joke. Okay. Who of you had actually the experience one time what it means to work and to be in a flow, that everything just flows out of your mind through your hand into the keyboard and you did some really great piece of software and surprise, no bugs. It worked right away. Anybody who had this experience up to now, please. Describe it. How was that? How did you reach it?
I was...
Take it. Right to your
mouth. Well, I was... I don't know how to say it. Surprised. I did, whoa, what have I done? Where are the bugs still, I think?
So it just happens by the surprise and you don't know how it happens. Did you know why it stopped?
Why it stopped? Perhaps I did start to think a bit more complicated, I don't know.
Okay, who else was in the flow?
The feeling how it was like writing the code itself or yeah, it felt like actually not thinking about the piece itself I was writing, but it was more like like as you said, like writing down the stuff as it comes to your mind, and then it was constantly coming new, step after step. It was building up in my mind, and exactly as it was, I wrote it down.
Yeah, the others who have been in a flow, can you confirm this? That it's just happening, everything. Okay. Anybody here who actually is aware about what stopped this flow?
My email account.
Here we go. The email account, right. What stopped? Let's do it another approach. Anybody here who is aware about how to get into a flow. Yeah.
Well, yeah, it's not a guarantee, but if you avoid distractions and try to imagine or focus on one problem for a certain amount of time, then the risk is very high that you go into this tunnel. Or
the risk, the positive risk to get into a flow. They're very well said, a risk. Okay. Yeah, it's really, it is about concentration, it's about focusing, and it's about, right, not looking into your emails, because distractions from your work, if you're in a flow, is very dangerous. Like, I just spoke to a trainer who is into memorizing training, and he said he's doing one exercise with his students, memorizing things, like I'm packing my bag and I put into my bag something and this and that and what else. And he is telling his students, okay, now calculate what is 3 plus 100. They have to calculate maybe 2 or 3 calculations. And then they are asked, okay, tell me what's in the bag. And the easy exercise they have done before was not so easy just after 1 or 2 calculations they had to make, because they got distracted from their focus. Now comes the bad news. To actually get into a flow, yeah, like you said, avoid distractions, but it is hard work. It is a kind of like a roller coaster. At the start, you really have to climb. Being on a flow, like you have described it, everything is just flowing through you, like it's running by itself. Actually, you're not doing it yourself. You're just witness of it. Then you're on a very high level, a very high energy level, or you can say concentration level. Roller coaster, go up. This is difficult, needs energy, needs concentration, needs focus. Even more focus, energy, and concentration than staying on that level. You reach it by risk or by chance or by surprise, and then comes the destruction. The whole energy you put into this is wasted. Now, the normal business day is like this. You're there, you get distracted every 5 minutes, 10 minutes, whatever. There was scientific research about it. How long does it take for normal concentration? Not talking of any flow experience. Normal concentration, if you're doing the coding, if you have a clear picture of the subroutine you're currently coding in front of you, you get distracted by just one single question, which has nothing to do with what you're doing. How long will it take you to get into this concentration mode? Guesses, please. 20 minutes. 20 minutes, so fast. Other guesses. 40 minutes. Want to hear more? One day? No, that is too much. Actually, 40 minutes is pretty good. They had an average of 45 minutes. Now, think of it of a normal business day of a developer getting distracted again and again and again. They have no chance to get on the concentration level, not talking about the flow level. A funny thing, I thought about it, and I thought about how can I get to the concentration level, how can I realize to go on the flow level, not by surprise or by risk, but by intention, and I went through the internet and looked also about others dealing with Zen and dealing with computer or with work in general. And the Americans have been a little bit ahead of us. They have something called Zen hours. So how to solve this riddle of being all day work and not getting disrupted by phone calls, emails, and something like this. Of course, shut down your email. Nobody is supposed to answer an email right the minute it arrives. Okay, if you work in support, but then you're doing support work. Maybe there's a possibility for you to have Zen hours where you agree in the office not to disturb any other of your employees, of your colleagues, with any questions. Because think of it, if you ask them, if you disturb them, they lose 45 minutes in average. You have a question, something's going wrong, you say, oh, if I Google now and if I do the research, that will take me 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, this is wasted time. My colleague knows perfectly, I'm asking him. No, it's cheaper and better for everybody if you go into it yourself, do the research, do the Googling, and everything you can't solve within 15 minutes, that has time to stay there and to be hold on until Zen hours are over. Then get together and do something. Okay, so this is the disruption from outside, like mails, like company chats. Who of you have a company chat going on? Who of you likes having a company chat going on and enjoys it? One at least. Funny, huh? It's the latest shit. Everybody has to have hip chat or something else going on. And actually, what does it do? It destroys your all-day life. You have to put an enormous amount of energy into your work and to your concentration, and at night, you know, 8 hours have passed, or 10 hours, or 12 hours, or whatever, and I achieved nothing. Maybe one subroutine, which is bugger all over the world, all over the place. You know, you have to work 2 days on this subroutine to get all the bugs out which are in there. And your energy is wasted. You go home, you're tired, you just want to have a beer and see nothing else, nobody else. Now imagine if you go to office, if you have the chance to work for your own, to get at least on the concentration level and get working. That would be amazing. Maybe 2 times a day, in the morning, in the afternoon, having 10 hours at least, 1 or 2 or maybe even 3 hours, 2 times a day, and get work actually done. We have another problem. If we really are able to implement 10 hours in the company, if you're really sitting there, if you don't get disturbed, we have another problem which keeps us away from concentration and from flow. Anybody has an idea about it?
Maybe the open browser windows, like all the procrastination, Facebook, I mean, I don't use it, but there's always the opportunity to switch the browser tab and, yeah, go to something when you don't really proceed in work, and then you, let's see what the latest news are and IT news, and then you're already gone away again.
Yeah, and I'm counting it in with the email thing as well as telephone. There's a nice thing. Usually you need one developer who's answering the telephone to solve really important and fast needed solutions to clients who call. No problem if you're a little bit more than just one person. Like switch, if you're a team of five, why not have one employee at one day who's doing the phone call service, picking up the phones, solving problems as he can, noting down problems he can't solve without the others for after the 10 hours, and just rotate. Anyway, there's another thing. Who has taken a shower today? Who hasn't brushed his or her teeth today? Okay. So you're clean. Maybe outside. Ever have been in a room of silence with no other distractions? You know how this feels? What is going on then? Your mind starting to present you the latest movie from your mind? Maybe you have trouble in private life and you have emotions of rage, or there's a problem going on that keeps you busy in mind. Is it possible in that state of mind to concentrate on work or even go into a flow? No way. When did you clean your mind last time? Who's I did not ask for formal C for clearing the cache and formatting the hard drive. No. Yeah, actually, this is a problem. If you don't do it with alcohol, yeah, okay. everybody's dealing about your cleanliness in terms of brushing your teeth, taking shower, but nobody is taking care of mind. And it's a bit like a computer. Think of it like you're using your computer and you're loading things into the random access memory, but you're not clearing things as you don't need them anymore. What happens is the thing, the damn thing, the computer gets slower and slower and slower, and at some point, that's it, nothing works. It's the same with your mind, by the way. You're actually caring about mind cleanliness every night while sleeping, but only in a way that you're able to survive anymore, not to go nuts. That's why it is so easy to actually foltern, who's English profi, torture somebody by keeping him away from sleeping. That's why, because his random access memory will get filled up and you go nuts. Sleeping is just preventing you from going nuts. It's like using your kitchen, not cleaning up, but only the plate you're needing right now for the next meal. But the rest of the kitchen is a mess. Any ideas how to deal with that? Good news. There are so-called hermetic principles, and one of them, this is coming from esoteric thingy, but not from the love and peace fraction, but working and looking for yourself, making yourself better. And it says, as inside, so outside. As outside, so inside. So if you want to clean your mind, a good job is to clean your surrounding. Clean up your office, your workspace. Just think about how does your table look like when you work. what's on the table. Usually I see a stacks of paperwork, a mobile pad, at least two monitors, I guess, keyboard, mouse, telephone, lots of stuff, don't know. Is this realistic? Everybody seems to agree. What I suggest you go home, clean up your table, and just test it, how this will change your work. If it will make it easier to concentrate on your work. I tried it, it worked. And I was so into it, I said, okay, this was a great step. I want to go a step further. You have a second table. This is called desktop. Background, thousands of icons on the desktop. Who knows that? Clean up your desktop. No background, no icons, just black. Like this. That's my desktop, black. Depending on your system, there are different ways, but there are ways for every operating system to actually kick off dock bars, menus, and stuff. The desktop should look like this. Try it, and you'll be surprised. I was, because it was even easier to get concentrated. So I thought, okay, that can't be the end. I want more. And I had a look at my applications, like your IDE, or if you're not a developer, like Word. Ever had a look at it with all the icons on top? How many of these icons do you actually use? Or are you the guy like me? You said 17, but are you a guy like me who knows perfectly the shortcuts on the keyboard for the actions which we are doing regularly, and actually we don't need the icons? So why don't get rid of the icons? I don't know a single app who's which you're not able to just kill the icons. This is my suggestion. Clean up your workspace. Write to your apps from the room, over the table, over the desktop, write to the apps, and see if this works. As inside, so outside. Maybe this has influence on your mind. You can do better than that. You can actually go actively and work with your mind. And it's very easy. There are apps for that. Like everybody here in the room loves apps, I know that. These apps are good for Android, and they are there for Apple as well. They do not cost very much, and the app I would suggest to try out is the mindfulness app. In Germany, it's Achtsamkeits-App. This app is available in English, in German, in Swedish. It's a Swedish manufacturer, and it's just great. All you have to do is to play it and to listen for 5 minutes. Just test it. I gave this talk several times. I got feedback from people about my suggestions. They said, this thing is really great. Should talk to them to get some kickback from my suggestions. What else? If you like to go further than that, cleaning up your mind, getting rid of emotions which hinder you to concentrate and to get into the flow. This is not only of working, but also any other activity you're doing. Like, think of your favorite hobby and think that some emotions and things that turn your mind keep you away from being happy and enjoy your activity. This is just crap. So if you want to clear your mind even more, then maybe try autogenous training or yoga or the most effective meditation. That's my suggestion. And even lately, I have written an article in the Harvard Business magazine. Managers don't do nothing with esoteric stuff and whatever. And there was a title, and it read, "Meditate 21 minutes daily unless you have a big workload. Then meditate longer." And actually it's like this. This is my experience from meditation. If you meditate, if you do a technique which clears your mind, and you don't have to meditate, like I said, Mindful App does a great job already. Yoga will do, sports will do, but sports is not that good as it seems in the moment you're doing sports, because just think how long it takes after you took the shower, after your sports, until your mind starts spinning again. This is a case of minutes, or half an hour, or an hour, and you're back into your mind spins again. Sport is good, nevertheless. If you do that, you will encounter that you will need less sleep. Because the body actually needs about, people say, who know about it really good, they say the body, the physical body, needs about 4 to 5 hours sleep a day, not any more. The rest we are sleeping is just that surviving kind of clearing the mind with dreams. That's it. All these stuff which I just suggested to you is more efficient than just dreaming. So, as a consequence, you will need less sleep. Have more free time. What else? Focus. We said focus. I said 10 hours. Great stuff. We have had several talks here the last days which have been about agile working, about Scrum, Kanban and things. People who know Kanban use the term work in progress, describing how much activities or how much tickets or whatever I do at the very same time in parallel. Try to set the work in progress to a maximum of 1. And you'll be amazingly fast, because you can focus, you get into concentration, if you're good, into flow, and that makes you really fast. I promised with the title to give you the top tips. Zero one, don't disturb. Nor others, nor yourself. One zero, help yourself to focus. That's the tips. I'm at a conference, everybody gets it, hopefully. Okay, thank you. Maybe you get now the joke behind this koan. The master saying to his new student, "I'd love to give you something to help you in your progress, but in Zen, we have nothing." Actually, I'm not a Zen master. Luckily, if you got interested, if you want to get more in deep with this, if you think it's a good thing to have me with you in your company to analyze, to help, to see where you can improve, to easily work without meditation. I won't do meditation workshops. No fear of this. but I offer Zen working consultations. Just contact me. And that's about it. Any questions?